staying alive, staying alive, staying alive on an abandoned amusement park planet while trying to keep an alien delegation safe so that war does not break out between you and your own species and their species. Stay alive. Is a compilation graphic novels collecting chapters 0 to 2 of a webcomic that I had found while wandering the grounds of the Calgary Comic Entertainment Expo this year. I was interested by its premise, its wonderful art, its story and its characters, and the fact that there were a variety of pride flags that the artist and writer had on their table. You see, as of late, there seems to be this round of bashing while asexuals on Tumblr for some reason I can't fathom. So it was truly nice to come across a book where people across the LGBTQIA alphabet were, well, welcomed. The story has a simple premise. The HSV Concord sets forth with a diplomatic delegation from the CHOR, the Committee of Human and Orno Relations, to meet with a delegation from the Orno, a bird-like agender race. On the way to unclaimed space where negotiations are to take place, an accident occurs that strands both groups on an abandoned amusement park planet, where the only chance to leave is to play the games, gather tickets, and purchase the top prize, a long-range space communicator. It's a fun concept on its own, the idea of an abandoned amusement park planet, but when one takes into account the royal machinations of the throne of the Orno, that there are humans called Metas with amazing abilities akin to the X-Men, and its diverse cast of interesting characters, the graphic novel becomes that much better. The wonderful artwork of Finn Lucullon brings a sense of uniqueness to this comic that I often find missing from titles from the big two of Marvel and DC. Everyone looks and feels different, and that includes the bird-like Orno race. Standing tall and willowy, with feathers instead of hair, there's a liberal use of pastels in their color scheme that makes them truly stand out. The humans in this cast are no different in their uniqueness, with Cora Calypt being a black asexual woman who has to step up into a leadership position when the ship crashes, to Independence Lee being a rotund, fat Asian woman who wants everyone to get along. Collecting chapters 0 to 2 in this graphic novel, this book is a great entry into the series that I would recommend to anyone, and buying it would mean supporting the creators of this wonderful story, even if one can read the comic for free on their website. Speaking of their website, which is cb-comics.com, it comes with a soundtrack that the creators paid for, so supporting this comic supports artists and musicians alike. There's honestly a lot more about this book that I could go on and on about, such as just how devious and underhanded the machinations of the plot of the throne against other members of the royal court of the Orna really are. The awkward and embarrassing culture clashes between the humans and Ornos when they first meet. Just how cool that amusement park planet is. But it's something that I want you to go and check out for yourself. So please, go to cb-comics.com, check out that music, and support the creators of this wonderful story. I'm Triple J, that's all I got left to say. Take care.